Welcome to Lear Corporation. Lear Corporation is ranked number 154 on the Fortune 500 with world-class products designed, engineered and manufactured by a diverse team of talented employees. As a leading supplier of automotive seating and electrical, Lear serves its customers with global capabilities while maintaining individual commitment. Lear maintains 243 locations in 37 countries around the globe and employs approximately 150,000 employees. Lear is traded under the symbol LEA on the New York Stock Exchange. Lear was founded in 1917 in Detroit, Michigan as American Metal Products, a manufacturer of tubular welded and stamped assemblies, the automotive and aircraft industries. Since then, we have grown to meet changing needs of the industry with 18 major acquisitions since Lear went public in 1994. Lear Corporation's vision is to consistently be recognized as a supplier of choice, an employer of choice, the investment of choice, a company that supports the community where we do business. The Environmental Health and Safety Induction sets out general requirements that are to be adhered by all employees, visitors, and contractors performing work activities. You will now be presented with the basic rules and requirements that align to our global corporation policy and facility. We urge you to pay attention. In the event of a serious incident such as fire, you will be required to evacuate the premises following the emergency evacuation procedure. The emergency evacuation alarm will be triggered. You will be required to leave the facility and assemble in a designated assembly point outside. The marshal will ensure that the area is evacuated by all staff. The marshal will guide the staff from the designated area to the assembly point outside the facility. The marshal will do a roll call to ensure that everyone is accounted for. Once established, all personnel are present, the green flag will be raised. Once the all clear alarm is sounded, all staff may return to their areas of work. Do not panic in the event of emergency. Remain calm. Take instruction from the evacuation marshal or your on-site Lear Corporation contact. All persons on-site is subject to a security protocol. All visitors are required to sign in at reception. You should be accompanied by our on-site Lear Corporation contact at all times. A biometric system for Lear Corporation employees is used. Your fingerprint will allow you to gain access and leave the premises. For those employees using a tag or card, kindly keep it safe. A visitor's permit will be issued to contractors when driving the vehicle onto our site. Only the driver will be permitted to enter via the vehicle gate. All passengers are required to enter via the security office and be signed in separately. All vehicles will be searched, and visitor permits must be presented when exiting our facility. Adhere to the speed limit while driving inside the facility and do not block any entrances or other vehicles when parking inside. Please note that when on our premises, you are subject to all our EHS rules and requirements. We may ask you to leave in order to maintain our safety environment if necessary. People who enter our facility are required to wear protective gear for the designated areas. Please pay attention to the signage on each work area to determine the appropriate personal protective equipment and clothing for that area. Visitors are required to wear safety gear in designated areas. The following are optional provided you stay in the designated walkway: visibility vests, safety glasses, earplugs. Safety shoes are not provided by Lear Corporation. Contractors are required to come with their own PPE for the area they will be working in and report to the risk manager upon arrival. Some areas might require extra PPE related to the work done. Staff with chemical exposure will wear PPE to protect them, such as respiratory masks, acid restraint gear, gloves or aprons. The general Lear Corporation rules are: no person may take any action that will cause harm to themselves, others, or the environment. Mitigate all environmental emergencies such as spills or leaks or pipe ruptures or noxious emissions. A designated smoking area is provided on the premises. Please refrain from littering and use the ashtrays provided. No talking on cell phones while work is being conducted inside the manufacturing plant. Do not enter the site under the influence of alcohol or any intoxicating substance. Employees have the right to refuse to do work which is unsafe or life-threatening. If an unsafe work condition exists, this must be discussed with the supervisor. maintain equipment and tools and ensure they are in safe condition prior to use. Tools and equipment or machinery may only be used by trained and authorized people. Do not hurry or run downstairs or jump from high platforms or stairs. Always hold onto the handrail when going up or down a stairway. Use compressed air only on work surfaces and equipment. Blowing air off your body or clothes is not allowed. This may lead to serious injury. When using the streamer, stay clear of steam, wear gloves, and steer clear of hot surfaces. Report unsafe conditions and all injuries and illnesses, no matter how minor, before the end of your shift. Adherence to life-saving rules is critical to keep employees safe. There are 7 life-saving rules, namely safety devices and guards. Devices installed to assure safe machinery operation shall not be removed, tampered, or bypassed. Lockout or tagout. Lockout or tagout procedures must be followed. Electrical work or arc flash. Appropriate personal protective equipment must be used when electrical work is being done or where there is arc flash potential. Fall protection. Fall arrest systems must be used when working at unprotected heights of 1.82 meters or greater. Hot work permit. All personnel working on any operation involving an open flame or producing heat or sparks requires a hot work permit. Seat belts or restraints. All operators and passengers of powered industrial trucks and equipment must use available seat belts and restraint. Safety glasses. All personnel sewing hard profiles or installing power actuated restraint devices must wear safety glasses when operating machinery. Among our most important values is our commitment to the safety and well-being of all employees, visitors, and contractors. Building a zero-incident safety culture, where everyone feels responsible for safety in the workplace and protects their personal well-being and the well-being of others, reflects that commitment. We appreciate your adherence to support our zero-incident safety culture while on our premises. If there are any questions, ask your host, direct manager, or supervisor. Thank you and stay safe.